Hello, my wonderful first and second grade musical scholars. Time for another wonderful music lesson. Let's just warm up our singing voices with Hola. Hola. ¿Cómo estás? Muy bien. Gracias. Hola. Hola, la, 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 la. Hola. Hola, la, la. Hola. Hello. Good to be back with you again. And as you know, we're going to start with a short devotion. And so I'm getting my book ready because I'll need it. But even before this book, I need another book that's even more important. Here it is. It's my B-I-B-L-E, the Bible. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. We're going to talk about this wonderful book right now in our very short devotion. There are books that tell us anything we want to know, but there is one book like no other. It's called the Bible. It's really a library of 66 books, written by 37 different authors, all inspired by one God. It begins at the beginning of time, and it ends at the end of time and the beginning of eternity. In between, we read stories of great men and women of faith like Moses and Abraham. We read about the miracles of a mighty God who loves and saves his people. You can't put this book down without making a choice. Do you believe it? Will you trust in the God who wrote it? Yes, I will. That's why the B-I-B-L-E is the book for me. And I hope the book for you. So here is our short scripture verse from Psalm 119. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light for my path. Let me break that apart. Let me say part of it and you repeat it after me. Your word is a lamp to my feet. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light for my path. And a light for my path. Here's our short prayer for today. Father, I know that if we stand for nothing, we may fall for anything. So I stand on the Bible alone. Amen. And I'd like to sing a song right now that comes right from this Psalm 119. It's called Thy Word. And you're going to get to see the words on your screen. All right. There's a part that's called the refrain. And we sing that first. And then we sing verse 1. And then we go back to the refrain. I have it circled on your words that you'll see in a moment. And then we sing verse 2, and then we go back to the refrain again. The refrain is like the chorus, something that we always repeat several times during the song. So let me grab my guitar right now. You take a look at those words on your screen, and please, feel free to sing along with me. I just love the words. The words through the refrain are very easy, remember? Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto
again.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Verse 1.
When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, as you are near. Please be near me to the end.
Back to the refrain.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Sing it again.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Verse 2.
Now I will not forget your love for me, and yet my heart forever is wandering. Jesus, be my guide and hold me to your side. I will love you to the is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path, and a light unto my path. You're the light unto my path.
Beautiful song. Oh, I just love that. And I hope you loved it too. Well, all right, we're going to move on to something else right now. So let me get what I need to get ready. And today, my friends, we are going to be talking about two notes. We're going to talk about the shorter quarter note, and we're going to talk about the longer half note. Musicians like you and me, we like to learn how to read music, and these are just some of the notes that you will see in music. Now, guess what I'm going to do right now? I am going to turn these around like this, because guess what? It's still going to be a shorter quarter note and a longer half note. Sometimes you will see the stems going down, and sometimes you will see them going up. We'll talk about that in another lesson. But right now we've got the shorter quarter note and the longer half note. What these notes tell us is how many beats or counts are they going to get. When we see this quarter note, it's only going to get one count. When we see this half note, it's going to get two counts. One count, two counts. Or one count, two counts. Remember, the stem can be up or down. So what I'm going to do right now is I am going to hold a card up for you, and I want you to clap how many counts it gets. Remember, one or two. All right, you have to be ready. You have to be ready. Good, one count. That's right, two counts. All right, you know I might try and trick you a little bit. So, that's right, two counts. One count. All right, be ready. Like I said, things might change a little bit. I hope you're looking. How many counts? See, the stem is down, but it's still one count. How many counts? Two. That's it. That's right. Two claps, one clap. You've got that. So when we musicians, when we want to write music and we want other people to be able to read it, we use some of these notes. Remember what I called them? The quarter note, and I called it the shorter quarter note because it rhymes. It's an easy way to remember it, and it only gets one count. The longer half note gets two counts. Well, now I am going to show you something right here. And I'm getting something ready because I'm going to play a song for you in just a couple of seconds. But I have to cue the music up, get it ready. But I want to show you that the shorter turkey here is holding the card with the shorter quarter note, only one count. And of course, the longer turkey is holding a card with the half note, and it gets two counts. That's right. And if I had you writing on this sheet of paper right now, I would have you writing the number one above the quarter notes and the number two above the half notes. Let's look down here. When you see these notes, I want you to put up a finger, either one or two. I'm going to point to it, and you tell me how many counts that it gets. All right? So I'm going to point here. One, 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 two. That's it. And I'm going to try the next part, so be ready to do it by yourself. And if you said one, 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 two, you are right. Well, we're going to get a chance to hear this song right now. It's called Look Out, Tom Turkey. And I'm going to cue up the music quickly. All right, before I tell you exactly what to do, get that cued up. So what you are going to do is, first of all, listen to the song one time. Just right now, you're just going to listen. Here's the words. Going to do this time before I play it. This time what we're going to do is you can clap on because I'm holding the book. I'm going to slap my knees, but guess what? I'm only going to slap when I get to this longer half note, which means on these pink words it's going to be two. We're not going to do anything here on the yellow words. We know those all get one count, but when we get to the pink words it's going to be two. So just try and do it. Just try to follow along with me. Here we go. Able to do that. kind of fun just to learn about those quarter notes, shorter quarter notes, I call them, and longer half notes. All right. Well, good little music lesson right there. And now we are going to switch gears a little bit. Do you remember our song about the months of the year? That was a really fun song. We did it our last lesson. And if you were not part of our last lesson, no worries, because I am going to put the words up for you for the months of the year. Again, music is a great way to learn different things. If you set it to music, it's going to print itself in your brain, and it's so much easier to remember. So here's the months of the year, and it's short, so I will probably play it a couple of times. Let's do it one more time. Here we go. Make sure you're singing. I hope you remembered it, or if you go, I never heard that before, well, you learned a new song today. All right, let's have some fun with a song called Snowman Jump. All right, I am going to put the words on the screen for you. So what I want you to do is just listen, read along for the first time I play the song. The second time I play the song, you're going to get to stand up and jump every time you hear the word jump. But I do want to play it for you first so you can hear how it goes and you're ready to listen for that word jump. So here's Snowman Jump. Remember, you're listening the first time. Second time, I'll let you know when to stand up.
Thank you.
everybody, it's time to stand up. I'll still leave the words up on the screen, just in case you're kind of following along. But remember, when you hear the word jump, that's when you do the jumping. All right? Listen carefully. Here we go. Okay, I was imagining you jumping all over, and that was a great picture in my mind. Well, now we're going to switch gears a little bit, because next week we are celebrating the birthday of a very important man in our country's history, Martin Luther King Jr. Yes, we've got a special holiday for him, and I know you'll be talking about him. So I want you to know that he was born in 1929, and when he was the first 5 years of his life, he was known by the name Michael. But then his father went to Germany and learned all about Martin Luther King, and he was a senior, so he said, we're going to change our names to this. And they became known as Martin Luther King Sr. and Martin Luther King Jr. And Martin was a very, very smart child, and he actually skipped two grades when he was in high school, and he went to college when he was only 15. And at first, he didn't think that he was going to be a minister like his father and his grandfather, but then, you know, I think he heard the call of the Lord and decided, yes, I'm going to be a minister. But not only that, he knew that he had to fight. And when I say fight, I don't mean with fists or weapons. I mean with words. That he had to fight with words to get equal rights for Black people and actually for everybody. They're called civil rights. That everybody should be able to eat in whatever restaurant they want to, use whatever restroom or drinking fountain they wanted to. Everybody should have the right to vote. So this is what he fought for, again, using words, using peaceful demonstrations, peaceful protests. And that word got across because of that. So we're going to sing some songs about Martin Luther King right now. And these songs are going to be up on your screen, and I'll talk about each one. The first one that we're going to sing is called Freedom. Now, after I sing it through, you're going to go, I've already heard that song. Maybe you haven't heard these words, but you've already heard the song.
Freedom, freedom, let it ring, said Dr. King. Let us live in harmony, peace and love for you and me. Freedom, freedom, let it ring, said Dr. King.
And I am sure most of you probably said, that sounds like Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Remember, we've talked about this before in our lessons, that if there's something important we want to learn, we could put it to a song we already know. We want to learn about Dr. Martin Luther King. Let's put it to a melody we already know. So I'm going to do it again. You've got the words in front of you. Let's sing it. You know the melody. You just have to look at those simple words. Ready? Here we go.
Freedom, freedom, let it ring. Let it ring, said Dr. King. Let us live in harmony, peace and love for you and me. Freedom, freedom, let it ring, said Dr. King.
Pretty easy to learn about. Well, now we just move on to the next song, which is called Sing About Martin. And here's another great way to learn a song. Have something repeat. Have it repeat back and forth, like between the caller, I'm the call, and you're the responder, you're the response. So you sing whatever I sing. And here's another easy way to learn a song.
Sing about Martin, sing about Martin, sing about caring, sing about caring, sing about peace. All around the world, all around the world. Sing about Martin, sing about Martin, sing about loving, sing about loving, sing about peace, sing about peace. All around the world, all around the world.
All right, now this time we're going to sing it again. I'm not going to sing it twice like I did, because you're going to sing it after me. You bet.
Sing about Martin, sing about caring, sing about peace, all around the world. Sing about Martin, sing about loving, sing about peace.
About Martin Luther King, caring and loving, and definitely peace. Well, let's go to another song that you have in front of you. And this is a song called A Man Named King. Now, as you're looking at the words, you will notice it will say, once there was a man named King, and then there's a little star, or we call it an asterisk. Every time you see that little star or asterisk, that's when we sing Alleluia. So you're gonna get to do the Alleluia part every single time. You'll catch on. I know it's very easy because I can sing the rest. But of course, if you want to sing along with me, I would love to have you sing.
Hallelujah.
And finally, our last song, A Man with a Dream. Again, somebody took these words and put them to a familiar song. So if you know the song Bingo, B-I-N-G-O, they took that melody and put it to this song. Let me sing it through once, and guess what? You're also going to learn how to spell the song peace, the word peace in this song. So be on the lookout for it.
There was a man who had a dream. His name was Martin Luther King. Martin Luther King. Martin Luther King. Martin Luther King. His name was Martin Luther King. Dr. King, he had a dream. He wanted peace for everyone.
Short and sweet, to the tune of Bingo. All right, get ready. Let's do it again. We're going to sing through the whole song.
There was a man who had a dream. His name was Martin Luther King. Martin Luther King. Martin Luther King. Martin Luther King. His name was Martin Luther King.
Before it's time to go, I would just show you a couple of pictures. I'd like to show you this one of Dr. Martin Luther King in one of his protest marches. Peaceful march. Yes, holding signs stating that we want rights for black people. We want rights for everybody. So there's one picture. And then I thought I'd show you this one too. This is more like an illustration, but there he is giving one of his speeches, Dr. Martin Luther King, the man we celebrate next Monday. All right, my friends, thank you again for a wonderful music lesson. You learned a lot today. Those shorter quarters and those longer half notes. We had some good songs, the months of the year. Oh, please don't forget about our Bible, the B-I-B-L-E. And of course, our songs about Dr. Martin Luther King. So we've got to sing goodbye. And oh, yes, we love to sing Adios Amigos. So let's do it. Here we go. Adios Amigos. Adios, my friends. Hasta la vista. I'll see you again. La 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 la. Olé! So, my friends, please stay safe, stay healthy, and God's blessings to you until we meet again. Goodbye.